Yo, what's up? Long time no see, right? I think this is the first video I make about me talking to the camera in a very long time. So I feel a little bit nervous because I love the touch of do this, so try to bear with me. So I'm making this video because I finished the 16 folder goal I had, which was PFCing everything I have available. So I'm going to talk a little bit about my experience with the new charts, especially A3 charts. And I'm also going to do a shout out at the end. And then there's a little bonus, like a PFC bonus at the end. So you might want to watch that one. The first thing I want to talk about is why I quit the game in like 2020. I think it was around 2020. So as you already know, we got hit by the nasty C. So that forced me to quit the game entirely. And then around that time, I started finding other hobbies like crane machines. I think, like, if you know me well, you know what I'm talking about. I focused on that for quite a while. And then after everything got better, I wasn't really planning to go back, but I've been to the cardiologist. And then I was just checking normal stuff, and then the cardiologist told me that I should exercise because my cholesterol was a little high. So that's the main reason why I took the game back, and I'd say that's the main reason why I'm playing 16s and like going up, because basically that's where the money is. Like, if I want to like do something similar to a workout, I have to like sweat, heavy sweat. So that's why I decided to just go for hard stuff instead of like before focusing on the easy stuff. When I quit the game, I already completed the 16 folder, like A20 side. I think that I didn't quite finish A20 plus. I mean, I don't remember well because I wasn't going hard for A20 plus, not even A20. I remember I was like trying to do the best I could when we had DDR A's. And then like A20, there was like I quit, I came back. Like 1 month I play, 1 month I stopped playing. It was just like that. And until we got hit by, you know. So from A20, I'd say that there were a few songs like Never See You Again. I remember I tried to avoid that song for a long time just because of the BPM changes. And like, if you know me, you know I'm too lazy to be opening Stepmania or even checking YouTube videos to check gimmicks and stuff. I usually just waste the money, you know, that's what you can call it. Like, if I want to learn a song, I just play it straight from the machine, just hope for the best. And then I try to learn what I can. Sometimes I admit that when like I cannot get something well, I just check on YouTube and check like other players' strategies to tackle some like tricky parts of songs. But usually I just go for it and just hope for the best. So Never See You Again was one of those songs that gave me a lot of issues when it came out in A20. Like, for when I got it, I played like 4 times or 5 times until I got familiarized with the gimmicks again. And then it was just a matter of few tries, and yeah, I got rid of it quite fast, I'd say. Then there were other songs like Pierce the Sky. I remember that when they released the challenge chart for Pierce the Sky, I was out of shape. That was one time I quit the game for a few months, and then when I came back, like, I felt it when I played it. I felt so bad, so I decided to just not play it again. It took me a while to even triple A back then when we had A20. But then like when we got A3, I got used to play 16s, and it was pretty easy to get. Like, I got it pretty fast. So nothing to it, like, it wasn't terrible. And then we had Firestorm CSP, the challenge chart, which was also not that bad, but I was having issues with the chalk arrows. Like, I used to hit them like jumping, like, you know, if you know the parts that I'm telling you, like the jump part, I used to hit them while jumping instead, like with the new strategy. I'm using, which is like after the jumps, just hit the center, just go back to the jumps, and then hit the center, go back to the jumps. When I did it that way, it came out pretty fast. So also not that terrible. Like most of these songs just needed some adjustments, some like random adjustments, like just using like maybe double step or just going back to the center for some stuff, and it was just that. And then like learning gimmicks, basically that's it. So the four songs left, the last four songs were Good Sound United, then Panicholic. After that I had Gerbera. I got Gerbera, that was my second to last, and the last one I got was High and Low. So Good Sound United, I already told you about this, like gimmicks, I'm like, I play a song until I learn the gimmick. So it took a few tries also. When I say a few tries, I mean a few days and a few tries until I got familiarized. And then one thing I forgot to mention that is peculiar, like that is very, how do you say, it's very similar in, with these songs, is their BPM. Like these songs are 200 BPM and up, and I always had this issue with fast songs, that it's not, it's, I think it's because I don't really enjoy playing them, so I don't really dig in and try to get used or like build up the skill to do well at them. But when I came back to the game, we had these two songs I really enjoyed a lot, like Audio Wise and even the steps, like Typhoon, the 17 footer, and also Gerbera. Like Gerbera is a song that when I listened for the first time, like I thought this is a masterpiece, I love this song. So I started playing them, terrible at first, but like they helped me build that like foot speed for that kind of songs. After that we had Panicholic. Panicholic is a song that I thought I wouldn't be able to PFC, like never ever. One reason is the BPM, the other reason was like the jacks, like jacks at that BPM for me are very uncomfortable. I think those are two of my greatest weaknesses, like high BPM and jacks. But I was able to come up with a way to step the slow part, and it was a matter of just a few tries, and I was able to get it, and I even was able to get it with a decent perfect count, so I was very happy with that one. And then we have Gerbera. Gerbera was always giving me issues, of course, at first. After I came back, I went hard with like fast songs, so I got pretty used to the speed of Gerbera, and I was able to get it. But like the thing with these last two songs, Gerbera and High and Low, I was sick, I got the flu, but I wanted to go to the arcade so badly because I'm playing once or twice a week, and the thing is that when you wait that long, you start losing your skill, like especially like you know, your foot speed, your stamina, you start losing that. So the last songs I had are fast. I didn't want to like grind again and build up the skills so I could get them in the future, so I went for them while being sick. And you know, like I think like Gerbera was, I think it was a fluke to be honest, because I was feeling terrible that day. And then High and Low could have been a better PFC, but I'm still happy with it. So yeah, it was good. So even though I knew I could do better, at least on these last two songs, I'm still happy I was able to complete the 16 folder. So I've been thinking to do the best I can with the 17 folder. So the first thing I did was playing throughout all the songs, and there were some of them that felt like 18s to be honest, but I think it's because I still haven't built the physical condition to do well on this folder. So I guess it's just a matter of grinding until reaching that level, right? So the future goals would be first life for the 17s and try to get a AAA rank on them, full comboing them, and eventually perfect full combo them. If I'm able to do this, then I will try to do something with the 18s and see how it goes. Alright, now for shoutouts. So the first shoutout would be for Edwin, Hoyo, because that's basically my guy. When I'm like, and when I'm going to the arcade, he's the first one to know. Like, we're always chatting about the game. Like, he send me scores and I send him scores and we compete between each other. And so I'd say that he's been keeping me motivated to like to do well, to do better, to improve. So yeah, that's why I'm going to give him a shout out. Then I have a guy from the Philippines, if I recall correctly. Sorry. His name is Carl and he's also a good player. He has his YouTube channel. You can visit his YouTube channel up here. You can check it out. And he's an upcoming player. He's doing pretty well right now. I've seen him posting 15 PFCs and 16 PFCs, even some 17s. And I'm going to give a shout out to Chrono, because Chrono, you know, it's ironic because Chrono and I, we go way back. I know him for more than 15 years. I say like about 19 years. And so I saw him developing in the game. And I say it's ironic because right now he's coaching me to play the hard stuff, like to do well on 18s. And yeah, like support. And then like he's been doing pretty well lately in tournaments. I mean, he's really always been doing well, but like he's been like doing outstandingly well lately. And that's also motivation. So shout out for Chrono too, and shout out to everyone that's been supporting my goals and supporting the channel. And yeah, let's see how it goes from now on. So as I was saying, there's a little bonus PFC, and technically speaking, with this PFC I can say that I really completed the 16th folder, because this song is not on GP and it's not on any other stuff that I need to pay for. So I hope you enjoy the video, and please don't make fun of it. Thank you, and see you in the next one. Peace.